Christian author.
Women's rights activist.
Nursery rhyme writer.
Poet.
Editor.
Publisher.
And the reason Thanksgiving is a national holiday.
How are all these related?
Sarah Hale.
Sarah Hale was born in Newport, New Hampshire on October 24, 1788, and died on April 30, 1879, in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania.
In her young life, she lived with her mother, Martha, father, Captain Gordon, and brother, Horatio. Horatio went to Dartmouth College, but because Sarah was a girl, she was not allowed. So, her mother taught her using classic books in their home. Additionally, Sarah Hale was very religious. She used her many writing pieces to share her beliefs about God.
In 1813, Sarah, as a school teacher, married David Hale, an attorney. They had five children, and David died unexpectedly. With her five children to support independently, Sarah realized her passion for writing. Hale's first novel, called Northwood, about anti-slavery, caught attention, and then she became a very established editor.
Sarah Hale was a women's rights activist and set a standard for many people who were a part of the women's rights movement. A better time is coming. Women capable of using their facilities for the improvement of society will not much longer remain in the castle of indolence. With it, those of my sex who are urging onward into the industrial pursuits and other professions appropriate to men might turn their attention to the improvement in domestic economy. Here is an open field where their hands and hearts, as well as hands, may find ample scope and noble objects, Hale said, showing her view on women's rights.
She wrote the famous nursery rhyme, Mary Had a Little Lamb, and was the editor of Ladies' Magazine, also known as American Ladies' Magazine. She published famous poets' pieces, such as Edgar Allan Poe, Nathaniel Hawthorne, and Harriet Beecher Stowe, giving them up to 150,000 readers.
She wrote to many different presidents, including Millard Fillmore, James Buchanan, Zachary Taylor, Franklin Pierce, and Abraham Lincoln.
Author of Godey's Lady Book and many other books, Sarah Hale was an established, prominent, and esteemed woman who had many great achievements.
Sarah Hale, the mother of Thanksgiving, changed the course of history through exploration, encounter, and exchange.
Thanksgiving, the holiday we adore, is not recognized for its true value anymore.
It was a feast, harvest, and celebration.
Now we try to keep the tradition alive by watching football and eating more than we can handle. The Pilgrims celebrated their first Thanksgiving feast with the Wampanoag Native Americans in 1621, although it was not a national holiday until 1863.
They feasted at Plymouth, Massachusetts. They celebrated a great harvest and peace between the two communities. It was a three-day celebration, not just one meal.
The Pilgrims and Indians came together and ate many different foods. They ate what we call untraditional Thanksgiving foods, such as goose, deer, and shellfish.
This tradition continued for many years after as an unrecognized holiday. On Thursday, November 26, 1789, President George Washington declared the first national Thanksgiving. However, it was not annually celebrated nationwide until Sarah Hale stepped in. It is said that it took over 200 years for it to be celebrated officially.
After Sarah Hale and Abraham Lincoln took action, more Thanksgiving traditions such as the Macy's Day Parade, Black Friday, and Thanksgiving football
developed, and they are still around today.
Sarah Hale is called the mother of Thanksgiving. She made Thanksgiving a national holiday with help from Abraham Lincoln. Her ideas took around 38 years to be placed into action.
Previously, Sarah had explored all her options by writing letters to two governors and several Navy commanders. She also sent letters to four other presidents prior to Lincoln, as stated earlier.
She wrote to Lincoln on their unofficial Thanksgiving of that time, which was September 28, 1863. Lincoln was the one who finally made Thanksgiving a national holiday for the U.S.
Her letter stated that she and many other people felt a need for a nationally recognized Thanksgiving. A resident in the United States coming up on a civil war, Hale felt a national annual holiday would bring the nation into unity. In the letter, she specifically said, "You may have observed that for some years in past, there has been an increasing interest felt in our land to have the Thanksgiving held on the same day
in all the states. It now needs national recognition and authoritative fixation only to become permanently an American custom and institution.
Additionally, towards the end of the document, Sarah writes, "Now, the purpose of this letter is to entreat President Lincoln to put forth his proclamation appointing the last Thursday, November, which falls this year on the 26th, as the National Thanksgiving."
Not only did she make Thanksgiving a national holiday, but Sarah wrote recipes for modern Thanksgiving customs such as pumpkin pie, turkey, and stuffing.
Lincoln responded with a proclamation stating he too felt that the holiday needed to be nationally noted. His speech was actually written by Secretary of State William Seward. In his proclamation, he said the following, "I do therefore invite my fellow citizens in every part of the United States, and also those who are at sea and those who are sojourning in foreign lands, to set apart and observe the last Thursday of November next as a day of thanksgiving and prayer to our beneficent Father who dwelleth in the heavens."
Lincoln's speech was the start of a new American era. He started a family tradition that has lasted until today and will continue for many generations after. However, in 1939, President Franklin Roosevelt changed what Lincoln had established for a Thanksgiving date. Lincoln had placed Thanksgiving on the last Thursday of November, but Roosevelt revised it to be on the third Thursday, and it is like that today.
Sarah Hill explored herself by doing things most women would not have even dreamed of doing. Hill endured criticism in tough times as a single parent, and her accomplishments are forever remembered in history. She set a precedent for women involved in girls' education and women's rights, like Susan B. Anthony and Elizabeth Cady Stanton.
Sarah Hale encountered many obstacles in her journey for Thanksgiving. She wrote to over 8 people, and even though she did not succeed, she persevered until her goal was achieved. It took her 38 years to reach that point. She never gave up.
Sarah Hale exchanged with President Lincoln when she wrote the Thanksgiving letter to him. In response, Lincoln officially announced Thanksgiving to be a national holiday, and Sarah's life's work was finally done. Sarah and Abraham's exchange paid off, and the exchange changed history.
To conclude, Sarah Hale explored herself, encountered obstacles, and exchanged with President Lincoln.
By making Thanksgiving a national holiday, Sarah Hale changed the course of American history and the United States as we know it.
Without Sarah and her determination, we would not have a day to celebrate our gratitude. We thank Sarah Hale for what she has done.